Happy Sunday to you, everyone. If you don't mind, I want to show you something here real quick. Let me put the camera around. Okay, I'm standing right here on the banks of the Mississippi River. It's a very, very wide river, but if you ever found yourself in a survival situation or you're just on a journey and you suddenly have to cross a very large body of water, it sure does help if you know how far it is to the other side over there. But in many situations, when you're in a hurry, or again, it's a survival and everything counts, every second counts, every minute counts, you need to decide, hey, can I wade across that body of water? Can I swim across that body of water? Or am I gonna have to build something that floats and then paddle my way across that river? Well, one of the quick ways you can find out about how far it is across that river is if you're wearing a hat, take the bill of your cap. I'm gonna put one right here in front of the camera. Do my best to do it here. And all you do is you bring your hat down until it touches the bank that you're standing on. And then tuck your chin to your chest. Slowly raise your head until your bill touches the other side of the river, the bank on the other side. And then keep your head in exactly that position. Turn your head and now face it down the land in which you're standing on, the bank in which you're standing. And what I'll do for you, I guess that wasn't a really good example there. I'm trying my best to operate this camera by myself and give you guys an example. But really what you do is you just take your cap, make sure it's set right above your eyes, and walk up to the bank, tuck your chin down till the bill of your hat is right there touching the very edge of the bank that you're standing on. Then slowly lift your head until the bill of your cap is now touching the bank on the other side. And then without moving your head up or down, turn your body so that your bill crosses the land which you're standing on. And when you do, mark exactly where that bill touches. Look around for any sort of thing that you can mark, like a tree, boulder, rise in the land, and then walk that over. And if you ever follow my video about pace speeds, you should always have a good idea. Anytime you're out and about, you're out in the wilderness, you should pretty much know what is the length of my natural strides, whether when I'm going uphill, when I'm going downhill, when I'm in rugged terrain, when I'm in fairly easy terrain, what is the approximate length of my stride? And then walk it off all the way down there to where that point was that you saw. And that'll give you an approximate distance across the river. And the theme of today's video is about approximate, what I call the 70% rule. Yesterday's video, I talked about my mentor and how he saved our lives with an avalanche. And if you go back and watch that video, I'm not sure to this day if he was 100% sure that an avalanche was coming down that mountain. But in a survival situation, and in so many things that we do in our own lives, go by the 70% rule. You hear all the time, give it 110%. You gotta give it 100%. If 100% is not good enough, well then you shouldn't be doing this program, or you shouldn't be a part of this team, so on and so forth. I'll tell you what, I've been part of some pretty elite teams, and there was many times that we lived by the 70% rule. Yesterday, my mentor in that video that I talked about yesterday, was he 100% sure? I don't think he was. Was he 70% sure? I think he was. And 70% sure meant that we moved. We didn't hesitate and we got out of that area. And so many times I see this, gotta get it right, 100% right, 110% right. I see this all the time in dog training. And I hear it all the time from other dog trainers. I hear it all the time from even veterinarians. I hear from other dog owners. It's all over the whole community. It's gotta be perfect. The dog has to sit perfect. The dog has to heal perfect. Everyone has to be perfect, 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 perfect. No, you don't. Go by the 70% rule, because otherwise, if you try to be perfect every time you're training your dog, every time you try to care for your dog, you will suffer from paralysis by analysis. And it happens so much. We hear these big terms, behavioral terms that people throw out there left and right. Hey, make sure that you're not using aversive. Make sure you're only using positive, positive, and positive punishment if you're using punishment. And good God, all that does is that just sabotages your brain. Out in the wild, when you're in a survival situation, just keep a simple, stupid rule. And I preach that every time I try to hop on these videos in some way or some fashion. I preach about keep it simple, stupid. And now I'm telling you, yesterday I told you about the rule of three, the combat rule of three. Now today I'm talking about the rule of 70%. 70% is often good enough. Don't get bogged down. If your dog gets stuck, doing a down command, heel command, stay command, place, quiet. Don't jump on me. Don't jump on anyone else while you're doing it. All these behaviors. If all of a sudden you just stop, the progress just seems to stop, well, then you stop. Just a second. Okay, look for those anomalies. You see three anomalies? Just continue to proceed. Do something. Don't get bogged down thinking about it too much. Just continue moving through. Either you or the dog will eventually figure it out. But man, so many times people come up to see me and I go, so what's going on? What's up with you and your dog? And they start talking to me. And finally, after about 20 minutes, I just kind of disrupt them and go, okay, hey. Oh my gosh. No wonder you're in the situation that you're in. You are suffering from paralysis by analysis. You're overthinking it. And nature doesn't want you to do that. And that's why if your stress response goes up super high, you're in a traumatic event, a very scary event, an accident, many life-saving type events, you'll finally reach a place in which your cognition is no longer enhanced. It'll be enhanced to the point where you will literally black out. You'll be conscious. You'll be aware of what, you won't be aware of what you're doing though. You will be breathing, you'll be moving, you'll be taking all sorts of actions, but you won't be aware of it until later on someone reminds you to you. But that's just your brain taking over and saying, hey, Bryan, you did a great job. I really appreciate you trying to get out of the situation. You relied upon your skill set, upon your memory, all the experiences you have in your life. But you know what? Things are getting pretty dire here. I'm going to take over from here. And then your brain's going to work off procedural memory instead of all that explicit stuff that you've got going on in declarative type learning. It just takes over. You just kind of black out. And you're doing it, but you don't remember it. And that's what can happen sometimes on a very conscious level is when people just get stuck. They get bogged down. They get frozen because they're afraid to make a mistake. I'm telling you what, action pays big dividends. I've always told people, man, even if you make a mistake, make it affirmatively. Make it with action. Man, make that big mistake. There you go. You'll learn from it. We'll all get through it. Any action is better than no action. If you ever catch yourself getting bogged down, you're trying to be perfect, you're trying to create that perfect sit and that perfect heel and that perfect come to me when called, I mean, dead smack right here in the middle. Just think about sometimes what's known as the rule of 70%. I don't know if I held my bill down right now, looked across the mighty Mississippi, turned it, or looking down the park. If I paced that off, 100% accurate? No. But I'll be accurate enough to know what strategy I need to employ to get across that river. I'll know if that thing's way too far for me to swim across. I'll know things like that because I got close enough. So guys do the same thing. Perfect. Just close enough for, you know, kind of like, what is it, horseshoes? Just gotta get close? Same thing. That's all you have to do. Perfection will come with time. Have to be perfect practice because you can end up burning out your dog and burning out yourself. 70% is good. That's real good. Just work on that. And 100% may come, may not. But you may just find out that 70% is good enough. Hunk out, dog. Where'd you go, by the way? Oh, there you are. You're hanging out down there. Okay. He's always hanging around for me. He's waiting for me to get done with these videos because he always knows as soon as I get done, I'll throw the ball. And that he's about 100% sure of. Not just 70%. Okay, guys, 70% rule. Keep it in your lives, personal lives, everything that you do. You don't